In this chapter, we're going to look at operating a video switcher. Now, I know this can seem very overwhelming with all the lights and the buttons, but it's important to remember that all switchers, big or small, operate in a similar fashion. They bring in all your sources and redistribute them as you wish. The first thing to know is this row of buttons here. This is called a bus. There are at least two of these on every switcher, a program bus and a preview bus. Each bus is exactly the same and shows you all the sources coming into the switcher. The program bus shows you what is on program or going out of the switcher for recording or live to the screens. The preview bus shows you what is set to go next to the program. You can select a source by either pushing the button on the program bus, which would be a cut, or by selecting it first on preview and then using the cut button or the fader bar for a dissolve. You can add a key, like a name super from graphics. Just select the key button. You can usually set the source that this button uses to make the key. Some switchers will let you do a chroma key or a luminous key. This can all be set up before production. There is also a button called Auto Trans. This button will automatically do a transition from preview to program at a preset rate, using whatever transition you have chosen, like a dissolve or a wipe. Now, some switchers will have extra features like auxiliary sends, or that will send signals to other locations, like monitors or maybe a different room. But for most productions, these basic functions are all you need to know. And this is the basic functionality of a video switcher.